Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel, where we deep dive into the world of pro audio gear. Now, if you're into high-end compressors, this review is going to be for you, because today we're going to take a look at the Rupert Neve Designs 5254. Let's have a look at what makes it special. First off, the Diode Bridge compression design is inspired by the classic 2254 from around the late 1960s. Think of it as vintage compression, but with modern tweaks. Now, Rupert Neve have added some modern features into this classic design, the biggest of which, I guess, would be the sidechain high-pass filter. It ranges from 20 Hz to roughly 250, allowing you to avoid over-compressing low-end heavy material, bass, kick drums, that kind of thing. Plus, it's got fast and slow time constant settings, so you can switch between aggressive compression or smooth control depending on the mix. Not to mention, who doesn't love a good set of VU meters, which display gain reduction or output volume depending on which way you have it switched round. Alright, so let's have a look at the controls. You've got standard compression settings such as threshold, makeup gain, you've got a blend knob if you want to dial in some of the dry signal, and then you've got the high pass filter here, and then you can also engage and disengage the high pass. Now, the interesting thing about this compressor is you have different ratios, 1.5 to 1, 2 to 1, 3 to 1, 4 to 1, 6 to 1, all the way up to 8 to 1. Originally, there was a limiter circuit. This has been replaced for an 8 to 1 ratio. But the interesting thing is about this, you can't set the attack and release independently. You have this button, which ranges from fast, medium, slow, and auto. You then have this button, which is the fast button, essentially making these 70% quicker. So actually, you've got double the amount of attack and release settings, so you can have it fast or standard, as it were. Looking at the center section, you have two buttons here which change what the VU meters display, either out for the output or pushed in for gain reduction. You've then got an in-out comp-in button, which controls both left and right, and then you've got stereo link. Now, the really interesting thing about the way stereo link works is most people would assume that when stereo link is pushed, the left controls both, as that's how it is on other compressors, most of the compressors I've ever heard. On the 5254, the way it works is whichever channel, left or right, is doing the most gain reduction, that will be the channel that is the master. So you really need to watch your gain reduction meters, because if you're doing quite a lot of compression on the left and not so much on the right, and then you're dialing the right in, you're going to find it doesn't actually do anything. Whereas the same can be said the opposite way around. If you start dialing in compression quite heavily on the right will become the master. So one thing to watch out for. Let's jump into some audio examples. All right, let's hear it in action. So, got it on the drum bus at the moment in parallel, it's about 50-50. So let me just turn off that parallel compressor there and let's have a listen. As you can hear, it really makes them drums sing when you bring it in and out. And at almost any ratio and any speed, it sounds really, really musical. Next, we're going to have a listen to it on bass guitar, which it sounds really nice on. So, is the R&D 5254 worth it? Absolutely. If you've got cash to burn, and if you're looking for a versatile compressor that can deliver vintage warmth with modern precision. Whether it's a subtle control or aggressive pumping, the 5254 gives you a ton of options. Which is true. It is expensive though. But it has transformers inside, and it definitely has colour. It's definitely a colourful compressor, I will give it that. If you're looking for smooth, clean compression, I'd probably buy a distressor. If you're looking for something with a little bit of va-va-voom, God, that was a shit word. If you're looking for something with a little bit of character, the 5254 is going to give you that. That's it for today's review of the Rupert Neve Designs 5254 Dual Diode Bridge Compressor. Jesus, that is a mouthful. Let me know in the comments, what's your go-to compressor for mixed bosses? And don't forget, like, subscribe, and hit the bell for more gear reviews. And I've got some fantastic gear reviews on the way. So, thanks for watching. See you next time. Be well.